हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे माय नेक्स्ट लेक्चर इज रिलेटेड विद टेराफॉर्म। सो इन इनिशियल सेशन वी हैव सीन लाइक हाउ टू इंस्टॉल टेराफॉर्म ऑन योर लोकल मशीन, व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ टेराफॉर्म, हाउ वी कैन बिल्ड वर्किंग मशीन, प्लस हाउ टू मेक अ कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑन द मशीन वी कैन with the help of Terraform. This is what we will learn. So now in today's session, I am taking a very small lab where we will see how we can provisioning the instance on AWS cloud with the help of Terraform. So in today's lab, we will create two instances. One is S3 bucket and second one is the EC2 instance. And we will use Terraform as a infrastructure as a code. So in the Terraform, we will write a code with the extension of .tf file, and where we will provide all the basic information which is required to provisioning the these instances. So this is how it will work. So let's go to the infrastructure as a code. So I have written my code in the Visual Studio code, and I think you can see this code, right? So what are the basic parameters required to create any infra? So first of all, we have to provide the provider name. It's AWS. For Azure, we will use AZ, MS AZ, and then if it is the Google Cloud, then we will use the GCP. So as per the provider name, we will make a configuration. So in the provider name, we will provide the provider name. As a layman, like we are the new user, we don't know how to write a code and how to write a code in the SCL language. So for that, like Terraform is providing all kind of solutions. So let me show you how we can write this code. Let's go to the Terraform website. Here in the Terraform website, you just go and see the Terraform registry, where you will see the documentation. HashiCorp is providing all kind of cloud features where all type of providers are available, to whom we can configure with the help of Terraform. So 35 providers he already given a code modules. So you can just go to this URL, registry.terraform.io, namespace and HashiCorp. Click on the AWS one, and you can go in the documentation side. So for example, here we are working on EC2. Like, so we will go and see how EC2, we can configure the EC2 instance. So here you will get the EC2 details. So I am clicking on the EC2 tag. With the help of this, we can create a EC2 instance. So you will get all the basic information here. For example, the name, resource ID, key value, if you want, and the key and value, and you can provide all these details. So what we need to do is just copy and paste from here. Okay, so you can see like what I have done. I have created one AWS instance. Name is a web. I choose the ME. We can got this ME detail from our cloud instance also. So let me show you how we will get. So for example, like I'm launching the instance. First of all, we will get this detail, right? So we can copy this ME detail from here. Okay, if it is a 64 bit, and copy it, and you can paste. So you can see this is the same, or maybe not same, but yes, we can use the same value here. So let me change. Okay, now my ME detail is there. My instance type, which we have configured next to this, it's T2 micro, and the name of the instance will be the Hello World. I am not using the security group. I am not using the any other details. I am just taking as a default. Okay, so whenever we will write a code, first of all, what is required? It's required the reason where this instance will be created, and my access key and my secret key. Okay, these are the very basic requirement to create any infra with the help of infrastructure as a code. So with the help of this resource, we will create one AWS instance. Second, we will create one S3 bucket also. So if you want, let me remove it right now. We will create one instance only because it's a very basic layer. First time we are using this, and once it is done, okay, you can see I have written a code as aws.tf. TF is the mandatory part. .tf, when we are when we go and execute this, my Terraform will look into the TF file only. So when I write Terraform, okay, the basic command how we will get, so go and take Terraform help. You will see the main commands are init, by which we will initialize our code directory. It will validate our code, whatever the infrastructure code we have written in the file, it will validate all those. Plan, it will dry run of your infrastructure as a code, and it will give you the details after running your infrastructure as a code, what will happen. So in the plan, you will get all these details, what will happen once you will run the code. Once you apply that code, it will go and create the infrastructure on your AWS instance or whatever the provider name you have provided. It will create the infrastructure on that provider cloud, and the destroy within a second. When you click the Terraform destroy, it will destroy last run code you have implemented. It will destroy that instance. So we have to be very careful at the time of running this Terraform destroy code. Other commands we will look into later, but today, in the today session, we will just go and check these five main commands. Okay, so my Terraform, you have seen like I have written a code, you know my instance is there. So let's go and check. Now right now there is no running instances available, correct? So let's go in the PowerShell. I am just initiating it. Okay, so now my code is initiated. It will go and check the very immediate .tf file, and it will initiate it. Now I will go and validate my code. Terraform validate. Okay, so infrastructure as a code, whatever I have written in the .tf file, it will go and validate it. So you can see the successful configuration is valid. So whatever the configuration I have given, it's successfully validated, and there is no issue with the code. Now I will plan. So I will go and plan. So once I initiate in the plan, it will go and check my Terraform file, and you will see here what it will do. So let's go and check what happened when I run this code. Okay, just a second. Okay, so you can see here when I execute that code, it will go and check the ME which I have given. Okay, and it will create a tag name hello world. That's it. It will create an instance type as a T2 micro. So only these three parameters I have done. Rest it will take as a default. That's it. So now my plan is executed, my code is validated. So in a plan, I got the information like it will create one instance which name is hello world. So now I will go and Terraform, I will apply the Terraform apply. So here you will see it started, and it will ask me, are you sure to apply these changes in your infrastructure? So you can see here, yes. So I have to put full world as a yes. So when I press yes, we will go and check our EC2 instance, and we'll see what happened here. Just a second. So what is going on? Okay. Enter value, yes. Error somewhere in okay. You can see here the ME code is invalid. Why? Because there is a space which was not caught on the validation side. So let me go and change and correct my code. So here I will go and correct it. Now I have saved it. Go back. I will validate again. So this kind of validation, it will not capture, but it will capture the validation where the syntactical mistakes are there. Okay, so it's not a syntactical mistake, it's a space mistake which caught at the time of launching the instance. Now validate is done. I am again planning it. Okay, once this is done, we will go and apply. So planning is also done. Now apply. It is asking for yes. So you can see that my instance is ready to create. Let's go in your web URL, EC2 instance. We are on EC2 instance, yes. It will still creating. Okay. Okay. Okay, it's taking big time, maybe 30-40 seconds. Yes, okay, now you can see the hello world is there. It's running and it's initializing the check. So once the status check is 2x2, then our instance is ready to work. You can see here, the instance is created completely. The instance ID is this and the resource is added. So we will go here and check our resources. We will click on it, so we will get the details, the ME details. You can see which is the same 3D9. Okay, 3D9 ME detail is there. We have choose T2 micro, so all detail will be here. Okay, so security, it will take a default security. And then instance type, so we'll go and see the instance type also. Key pair, see, we did not give any details, so it will take everything is a either blank or whatever the default values are there which is required. So it could put all the values as like that. So here you can see VPC is there, subnet is there, okay, and all the required things are available, correct? Okay, the tags which we have done, yes, so hello world is there, yes, status check, so you can see right now it is still in process. Maybe once it is done, the 2x2 check will be there. So instance is still in a, okay, so 2x2 check is there. Now we will go and check the instance. Yes, so system reachability check passed and instance reachability check passed. State storage is default EBS, and you can see it will attached. Okay, and the root volume you can see. So all the informations are available now. Networking, yes, so you can see the VPC available, subnet is there, public IP address is there, correct? Okay, so all the basic information is already available here. We have not given the Elastic IP, so we will not able to see those. Now my instance is created with the help of Terraform. Now again the last command is pending to execute, which is Terraform destroy. So once we will run this command, it will destroy my instance which we have created. So Terraform destroy. Again it will ask us